Hello, this is Victor. I'm here with a new showcase, and this time I want to share with you the Excelsior Priest plus other miniatures that I paint for the Silver Tower. So this is the progress. These are the new miniatures. In the past I shared with you the Gaunt Summoner and some of the heroes, and here we are going to see another hero, the Excelsior Priest with the Griffhound. And then we have some of the Gvots, some three Zangors, and then Pink Horror, Blue Horrors, and the Small Horrors, I don't remember now the name. So let's make a look first on the Priest. Let's zoom in. At the end of the video I will put pictures on the tail of every of these miniatures. So For the Excelsior Priest, you know that I have a tutorial as well for the Griffhound, in case you want to know how it's painted. I decided to go for a different color for the Griffhound than the color of the first one I painted, the one from the Lord Castellan, and I went more for a grayish color with this green to simulate the feathers that we see in some of the bears. For the Excelsior Priest, I went for the traditional or for the base color, the white and red. That is the one we see on the book. And yeah, and this is the work. Okay, I tried to do some of the blue glowing that I did on the you see there on the hammer. Some of the glowing that I did also on the Stormcast Eternals. But so far, if you want to know more details, I have a painting tutorial. Just also see the book. You will see more details at the end of pictures. I also paint, you see here, three Zangors. These are very interesting miniatures to paint. I will do a tutorial how to paint one of the Zangors with the other three that I still have to paint. I went for blue and then this purplish, greenish blue skin. I did the gems in this type of deep purple, and then all the feathers and all the other things on this pinkish color. So the armor is blue trimmed with gold. See here the different ones. Okay, and this is the one with the big weapon. Then I also paint some of the grots. Or groots, I don't know really how to pronounce them. Four of them as well. Okay, so here you have. Okay. I went as well for this color scheme that we see on the book. So it's the black clothes and then the green skin. No, not too much to say. I did the webs in this type of white, and then the spiders I did them in red. So as well as the feathers of the arrows when they have it. So some small details on red, but mainly it's the black with the green skin. And then here we have on the other side, okay, the horrors. Let's see if we can. Sorry for this camera. So here we have the pink horror and the things called, I don't remember how I call the small ones. The ones that they paint like flames. I wanted to paint like flames without using any other color. I saw that some people is using green for the eyes. I tried to avoid, and then I go for what I call pink chew gum for the pink horror. I really like to go for this color on the horrors. I did here like the small patterns, and I wanted to go for the flames on the traditional yellow colors. I didn't want to go for different colors for the flames. On the blue horrors, I decided to do one more on the purplish spectrum, another more on the blue spectrum. Okay, you see this guy is more purplish, the other one is more on the blue. It's what I explained in one of my tutorials, that playing with, using the same base coat, but playing with the washes, you can go, and then of course the highlights, you can tweak the color to one direction or the other. So this is what I paint so far. And with that, I have almost painted half of the box, and I go slower than what I was expecting, but I really like how they look like. So now I will make some pictures, some more detailed pictures of these miniatures, keep tuned if you want to see the detailed pictures and more and better quality. Please leave the comment below, let me know what do you think. Another thing is that you see that the weapons that I did for the Zangors is the same color that I will use for the Cultist, is this type of copper color. I prefer to go for something different than the standard steel. So this is what you have here. Okay, and now I will go for pictures. Please leave the comment below, click a like if you have liked it, share, subscribe if you don't subscribe it, and you also can support me in Patreon. If you like the tutorials, if you like the videos that I have and you think that I deserve the support, you can support me in Patreon. As usual, thanks a lot for watching and see you again later. Bye!